is my name. I represent the good people of Surulere, Ogoluwa, Federal Constituency, area of Oyo State. Mr. Speaker, honorable colleagues, honestly speaking, the action is embarrassing. It's highly incredible. We cannot believe this can happen in this nation. Mr. Speaker, but I didn't want to go to the where my colleagues have spoken. But I just want us to know that we should think of this. It's like there's a little gap within the Nigerian people and the executive. Even if there's no provision for these people that they won this match, if there's no budgetary provision, national assemblies have made provision for service-wide vote. How many meaning that would take for the executive, the head of the government, to know what is going on in the nation? I know, I mean, if the SGF, the ministers are in common, I mean, if the gap is not too wide, they should be able to know and generate funds for these people. But it's like there's need for us to investigate how are they going, I mean, how Nigerian people can even access to this kind of problem when there's no provision for it. Because we make provision for it in the service level in case there's no provision, I mean, budgetary provision for this kind of thing. Mr. Speaker, honorable colleagues, I want to urge this committee, the Committee on Sport, to go deep into the investigation on the ministry. Even the treatment given to this player at the Cameroon, we were told a lot. So there's a lot of things for us to even investigate, to know the treatment given to them, even the transportation from Yaoundé to Douala. We were told that these people were, I mean, our players are put in the bus while the officials fly over. So a lot of things must be investigated about these people, Mr. Speaker. And most importantly, the financing of the sports ministry, the financing of the NFA and the Service Commission. Let us go deep into it. What is the problem? Is the bureaucracy there is too heavy for them? Let us break it and open the platform for Nigerians to benefit from it. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.